Today, we're taking a closer look at Hana, a new real-time canvas where you can design, animate, and add interactivity. Very similar to Spline's 3D editor, but for 2D. We'll take a quick tour to help you get familiar with the interface, and we'll go over the basic steps for creating animated and interactive 2D scenes, as well as how to export so you can add them to your website or app. Now, let's get started. First, let's look at how to create a 2D file. Once you're logged into your Spline account and you're on the Home or My File section, you'll see the Create button in the top right corner. Now let's click here, and as you can see, you can now choose between creating a 3D design or creating a 2D design with Hana. Now just click on Hana, and this will create a new file that, instead of using the 3D editor, it has an interface made to work easily in 2D mode. Let's take a moment to explore the interface. And, just like in the 3D editor, the left sidebar shows all the layers or elements in your scene. Here you can rename your file or click on this burger menu icon to quickly access other options like creating a new 2D file, duplicate, and more. In Hana, you can pan by pressing the scroll wheel on your mouse and dragging in the direction you want. If you're using a laptop, place two fingers on the trackpad and move them in the direction you want to go. You can zoom in or zoom out by using the scroll wheel on your mouse or by pinching or spreading two fingers on your trackpad. And right here is the top toolbar where you can quickly find the main tools you'll use to work on your 2D design. You can select the frame tool from the top menu or press the F key as a shortcut to quickly draw a frame. This will work as a container to help organize and structure your design, which you can move around your canvas. And if you want it to have a specific size, just select it and go to the right panel to adjust the width and height of your frame here. You can have multiple frames in the same file, perfect for working on different screens, layouts, or versions of your project. By clicking here, you can easily create 2D shapes. We'll explore how to edit them and add more effects later on. This is the text tool, which you can use to add text to your design and style it however you like by adjusting properties in the right panel. And here's the vector tool that allows you to freely draw and create shapes, which you can later edit by adjusting the vector points and refining the curves. You can bend your shape using the bend tool or simply click and drag directly to start bending right away. Hana allows you to create vector networks in a real-time environment. Vector networks let you connect more than two lines to a single point, making it easier to build a wide variety of shapes. Once you've added any animation or interactive events, you can click this play icon in the corner of the frame to preview or interact with your design without ever leaving your canvas. The right sidebar shows the property panels. If you have nothing selected, either by clicking on an empty area of your canvas or by pressing the escape key, you'll be able to adjust scene-wide settings like changing the background color here, or enabling or disabling presentation mode. Choosing a layout under responsive for presentation like contain, cover, actual, or responsive. And here, you can also enable or disable the snap options to help you design with more precision. But when you select a shape or 2D element, you'll see all the adjustable properties for it. You can adjust things like colors, add strokes, and even set up animations and interactions for your shapes. Now let's walk through them one by one. You can use the alignment tool to easily position and distribute elements. Just click on your shape, go to the right-hand panel, and choose how you want it to align within the frame. In the transform section, you can precisely move your shape by setting values for the X and Y axes and also control its rotation. These states and events options are what let you add animations and interactive events to your design. If you've used Spline before, this will feel familiar. If you're new, no worries. We'll go over this in more detail when we get to creating animations and interactions. You can use more specific size for your shapes by adjusting them in the right panel. And you can click here and use the lock icon to maintain the aspect ratio when adjusting the width or height. In Fill, you can click to add and change the color of your shape. You can adjust the opacity levels here and use the eyedropper to pick a color directly from your scene. You can also add an image to your design. In the Fill section, click here and choose the image option. Then click on this icon and select Upload to add your own image from your computer, or you can also drag and drop your image directly onto the canvas. You can add a stroke to your shape simply by clicking here. Here, you can also increase or decrease the thickness, making the stroke look bolder when you increase it or thinner and more delicate when you decrease it. You can change the stroke's opacity by adjusting this percentage value. And here you can choose where the stroke is placed in relation to the shape's edge. With Inside, the stroke is drawn inside the shape's edge. Using Outside, the stroke is drawn outside the shape's edge. And with Center, the stroke is centered on the edge, half inside and half outside. These are especially useful when working with custom shapes made using the vector tool. In Join, you can adjust how the points that connect or are inside the stroke will look. Meanwhile, in Cap, you can change how the ends of your stroke look. And here, you can add more effects to your shapes like drop shadow, inner shadow, or blur effects like layer blur and background blur. Once selected, click the settings icon to adjust properties like offset, blur, color, and opacity. You can toggle the effect on or off by clicking the eye icon. If you want to add more than one effect, just click the plus icon here. We could, for example, add a drop shadow to the ellipse and fine-tune the blur and color to make it softer and slightly bluish. This would help create a more natural and visually appealing effect, adding depth and subtlety to the design. You can experiment with these or add other effects, and to remove them, just click the minus icon. You can select multiple shapes and use Boolean modifiers. Use Union to combine the selected shapes into a single one. Subtract to remove the overlapping parts. It will always subtract the layer that is on top. And finally, use Intersect to keep only the overlapping area between the shapes. Now let's see how we can transform these vectors or 2D designs into animated and interactive experiences. This is where your project starts to come to life. First, let's review what states and events are. A state is simply how an object looks or behaves at a specific moment. In each state, you can change things like position, size, color, or any other attribute of your shape. Then you can create an animation or interaction that makes the object transition smoothly from one state to another. But how do you trigger those animations or interactions? You can do it using events. Events are what you use to make things happen, like starting a transition, playing an animation, or creating an interaction. You can add them simply by clicking the plus icon, and by clicking here, you'll find the available interactive event options you can use to trigger actions. You can use the start event to trigger actions as soon as the scene loads, perfect for simple animations and looping animations. You can use mouse events if you want animations to be triggered by cursor interaction or by touch input from a mobile device, like when you click or hover over an element or tap on it from a phone or tablet. When using mouse events, you can enable the pass-through option in the events panel. This lets mouse clicks go through the object and interact with objects behind it. If pass-through is disabled, the click will stop at the object that has the mouse event. You can also use key events to trigger actions when someone uses their keyboard, like when they press release or hold down a key. You can also use the look at or follow events if you want to make your designs face toward or follow the cursor or even another object. Let's recreate this interaction to understand it a bit better. First, we'll create an ellipse and center it using the alignment tools. Next, we're going to change the color of our shape here. Next, go to states and click the plus icon. We'll keep the base state as it is as our starting point, then select the new state and modify the size of the ellipse. So now we have two different sizes, one in the base state and one in the new state. Let's add a stroke by clicking the plus icon. I'll change the color to black and also increase the thickness. Then I'll go back to the base state and change the stroke color to black there as well. Now let's set the stroke position to inside. Let's adjust the stroke opacity here to something like maybe 80%, or maybe something lower, like 20%. I'm going to decrease the thickness a bit and set it to 40, but feel free to play around with it and adjust it however you like, depending on whether you want a thicker or thinner stroke for your shape. In the second state, I'll change the opacity to 0% so it looks like the stroke disappears during the animation. And just like that, we've defined the changes that will happen to our shape. Now let's add a new event. We'll keep it on start for now and click on transition. Here we can define the order of the transition in our animation or interaction. In this case, from base state to state, reflecting the changes we made to the ellipse in each state. And here, you can define the transition duration in seconds from state A to state B. Feel free to explore different values depending on whether you want a faster or slower transition. You can always click on your event to keep editing it and make further adjustments to the transition. By clicking here, you can choose from the different easing modes which can affect how smooth or dynamic the animation feels. Let's pick spring, and in the sequence section, set it to infinite and ping pong to create a looping animation. You can test your animation both from the canvas by hitting the play icon on the frame, or by directly entering play mode. Now I want this animation to play when my cursor gets close to the ellipse. Let's go back to the event. In the sequence section, I'll change the loop from infinite to none since we no longer need it. Then, instead of start, we'll select the mouse hover event. Now, when we preview the scene, you'll see the animation only triggers when the cursor hovers over the ellipse, making it an interactive experience. You can also make more changes. For example, you could select one of the states and change the color so it becomes part of the animation too. If we check the preview here, we can see that now not only the size and stroke change, but the color of the shape changes too. You can even group elements and add animations to the group, allowing multiple animations on a single element. For instance, here we grouped the ellipse and created a new state in the group to adjust its position. In the base state, it's placed lower, partially outside the frame. In the state, it's centered. Then we add a transition animation just like before and set the easing to spring. Now when we play it back, we get a nice intro animation where the shape moves into place and then is followed by the interactive effect when we hover over the ellipse. And once your frame is ready to be shared, you can export it by going to the export section and clicking on this icon. You can also export it by clicking the three-dot menu at the top right corner of the frame's border and select export to open the frame export panel. In the export panel, you'll find options such as exporting your frame as an embed link or as an image. The copy link option allows you to share your scene using a direct link or public URL. The copy embed code option lets you embed your scene into platforms and frameworks like Webflow, Framer, or standard HTML, JS environments. Before exporting your scene, you can customize several settings. For example, you can toggle the visibility of Hana's logo, enable or disable scrolling inside the embedded frame, and decide whether to show or hide the background color. You can also set the frame size. You can select Contain that adjusts the content so it fully fits inside the container without cropping, maintaining its aspect ratio. Cover that makes the content fill the entire container, also keeping the aspect ratio. Actual, that displays the content at its original size without scaling, and responsive, that allows the content to adapt to the container's size, which changes depending on the screen or device. If you make any changes to the scene or to the export settings, click Export to ensure the embed link is updated with the latest version. Then you can, for example, click here to copy the embed code, and after that, simply paste the script tags into the body of your website or place them inside an HTML embed block to integrate the scene. And that's it! Just copy and paste, and all the interactivity you created in HANA goes straight into your project without writing a single line of code. You can share your designs either just to show them or to give editing permissions. Just click here, and here you can see the option to copy this link to share it. You can adjust the permissions to decide if you want people to have access as viewers only, allowing them to duplicate your design, or as editors, which gives them full access to make changes to your file. Then just click on copy link and paste it wherever you want to share it. Or you can also choose the option only people invited can open this link. If you choose this option, just type the person's email here. And here you can choose whether you want to give them permission as a viewer or an editor. And then click the invite button so they'll get a notification by email. Now in My Files, you can hover over your design and then click this three dots icon. You will find options like open a new tab and others to organize your files, like rename them, move, share them, or archive. A great way to keep everything neat and easy to find. And that's it. This was just the first step to help you get familiar with HANA, but in the next tutorial, we'll recreate one interactive 2D design from scratch, step by step. We're excited to introduce this new feature and really value your feedback as we keep building Spline together. You can join our Discord community to share your designs, explorations, and thoughts with us. More 3D and now also 2D tutorials are on the way. See you in the next one.